Welcome to part 6 of this Unity tutorial series, where we're creating a survival shooter game using Unity's new implementation of the Entity Component System Pattern, or Unity ECS for short. In part 5, we began implementing player shooting by creating a system that tagged the player entity when the Fire 1 button was pressed. In this video, we'll continue our work by writing another system that'll remove this component after a certain period of time. In other words, we'll be implementing rate of fire. So, without further ado, let's get right into the video. Let's get started by creating a new system. I'll call it Cleanup Firing System and open it in the IDE. This will be a peer system, so let's derive it from the Job Component System class. Before we go any further, let's do a quick review. This is the Player Shooting System. It also derives from the Job Component System class, which means that it utilizes Unity's new C# job system. The C# job system was designed to make it easy to write highly efficient code that can run on multiple processors. It relies on multithreading, optimized memory layouts, and advanced compiling techniques to produce builds that run extremely well on a wider range of devices. The player shooting job is responsible for adding the firing component to an array of entities. It derives from iJobParallel4, which is basically a for loop that runs in parallel. The player shooting job is scheduled inside of the player shooting system's onUpdate method whenever the Fire 1 button is pressed. By the way, I got a bunch of comments about this code in part 5, and I've refactored it to be more efficient. If you see anything else like that, please continue to let me know. The data struct represents a concept that we've already seen in this series. Its purpose is to tell Unity what kind of entities this system is responsible for operating on. We facilitate this by adding a data field to the system and marking it with the inject attribute. Unity then uses reflection to provide an instance of the struct that's populated with all of the appropriate values. In this case, the component data array tells Unity to populate the struct with entities that have the weapon component, and the subtractive component tells Unity to ignore any entities that have the firing component. The entity array is populated with all of the entities that meet the component specification, and the length field is populated with a value that reflects the size of the entity array. It's a read-only field because if we were to modify the value by accident, the compiler would throw an error. Lastly, the player shooting barrier is a special class that we can use to perform actions on our entities. It's not safe to add, modify, or remove entities inside of jobs. But barriers live on the main thread, so we can use them to create a command buffer that queues up and execute actions when it's safe. All right, the review is over. Time for a pop quiz. Just kidding, no tests in this series. But we can use what we've learned to write our next system. Let's switch back to the Cleanup Firing System class. Like I mentioned before, the cleanup firing system will be responsible for removing the firing component from entities after a certain period of time. This will result in behavior that, in effect, will emulate rate of fire. To switch things up a bit, let's start by creating the data struct. The system will be modifying entities, so it'll need fields to store an entity array and its length. We only want to modify entities that have the firing component, so it'll also need a component data array. Now, let's add a data field to the cleanup firing system and mark it with the inject attribute. Again, Unity will take note of this attribute at startup and populate the field with an instance of data. We'll also need to inject a barrier system that we can use to modify our entities safely. Let's create one now. I'll call it Cleanup Firing Barrier. And add it as a field to the system with the inject attribute. The last thing we need to do is create the actual job and schedule it. I'll call it Cleanup Firing Job. Now, we can add an entity array, an entity component buffer, and implement our logic. Alright, we're almost there, but we're missing an important business rule. The job removes firing components from the entities immediately, but instead, we want to remove them after a certain period of time has elapsed. So we'll need to do a quick refactor. First, let's add a new field to the firing component. We're going to base the rate of fire logic on the time a bullet is fired. We'll subtract the fire time from the current time, and see if it's greater than some predefined period. If it is, then we'll remove the firing component. So let's add a float called fired at. And we'll initialize it when the component is added to an entity, which currently only happens in the player shooting system. Now, we can grab the current time from Unity's time class and pass it into the player shooting job. Now, let's switch back to the cleanup firing system and perform a check on the current time versus the time that the bullet was fired. We'll need to add fields for the current time and firing components to the job first, of course. And then we'll add a guard clause that returns if the difference is less than 0.5, which amounts to half a second. Lastly, we'll finish up the system by scheduling the job and passing in all of the appropriate values. And that's all there is to it. Let's switch to the editor and run the scene. We aren't generating bullets yet, so we'll need to open the entity debugger and select the weapon entity to see the results. Watch what happens when I press the Fire 1 button. The firing component is added and then subsequently removed half a second later. Now, watch what happens when I hold the Fire 1 button. Beautiful. Now we're ready for the fun part. The part where we actually generate bullets. If you'd like to download the project files for this video and support my content at the same time, please consider becoming a Tier 2 patron today. You can find a download link in the description and comments below. So, the results of all of our hard work has been a little boring so far, but I promise, in the next video, we'll start to see some bullets fly. And we'll implement a new style of system that reacts to changes made to entities. You won't want to miss it. If you found this Unity tutorial helpful, please leave a like and a comment letting me know what you thought. And for more videos just like this one, don't forget to subscribe with notifications on. I'll catch you in the next video. Thank you to all of my patrons, and a special shout out to Thomas, Chance McDonald, Glasswell Entertainment, Richard Stance, and Yakov.